the crucifixion, God is still protecting his son to make sure that only those who come around his son are those who want to be there and will worship him and honor him for who he is and what he has done. See, God doesn't want to let everybody into heaven because he wants to, but he can't because it would threaten the peace and the sanctity of heaven. It wouldn't be heaven anymore. It would be what we have here. So there's this division. We're in harvest. We're going to decide. We're going to divide the kingdoms between light and dark right now because everybody's here that needs to be here. Everyone's alive today that needs to be here. You know, and God even instructed to tell me to let the church know that between now and this time signing that peace agreement, you have plenty of time to have more children. Have children. There's plenty of room in heaven for more children. We're never short on children in heaven. We always can have more. And so the Lord really wants to encourage the birth rate amongst Christians in these last days. And don't worry about what the world may think of you or what the world may say of you of having children. Just do it because we're going to go home and we're going to take our children with us and we're going to finish the job of raising them in heaven.
You don't drive your car with the headlights off in the dark. So why run your life the same way? Church. Church. Give it a try.
This is episode 37. And as we begin reading here, I'm going to read Psalm 37. It's 1 through 40, 40 verses. So bear with me here. It's a Psalm of David. It says, "Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, so that thou shalt dwell in land and have a verily heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord, and trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and the judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Cease from anger, and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil, for evildoers shall be cut off, but those who wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. For yet a little while, and the wicked shall not be. Yea, they shall diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. But the meek shall inherit the earth, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. The wicked plotteth against the just, and gnasheth upon him with his teeth. The Lord shall laugh at him, for he sees the day is coming. The wicked have drawn out the sword, and have bent their bow, to cast down the poor and needy, and slay such as be as of upright conversation. Their sword shall enter into their own hearts, and their bows shall be broken. A little like a righteous man hath is better than the riches of the many wicked. For the arms of the wicked shall be broken, but the Lord upholdeth the righteous. The Lord knoweth the days of the upright, and their inheritance shall be forever. They shall not be ashamed the evil time, and in the days of famine they shall be satisfied. But the wicked shall perish, and the enemies of the Lord shall be as the fat of lambs. They shall consume into smoke, and they shall consume away. The wicked borroweth and payeth not again, but the righteous showeth mercy and giveth. For such be blessed of him shall inherit the earth. For such as be blessed of him shall inherit the earth, and they be cursed of him shall be cut off. The steps of the good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord uphold him with his hand. And I have been young, and now I am old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. He is ever merciful, and lendeth, and his seed is blessed. Depart from the evil, and do good, and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loveth judgment, and forsaketh not his saints. They are preserved forever, but the seed of the wicked shall be cut off. The righteous shall inherit the land, and dwell therein forever. The mouth of the righteous speaketh wisdom, and his tongue talketh of judgment." Nobody likes to hear that when we talk about judgment, obviously. But it looks like here, it says that the mouth of the righteous speaks wisdom and his tongue talketh of judgment. That's the righteous people who talk about the judgment of God. We're talking about the judgment of God now. And that's something that we need to be expressing to people. This is the judgment of God against the wicked. And who were the wicked? Those who took and made America their own. The law of his God is in his heart. None of his steps shall slide. The wicked watcheth the righteous and seeketh to slay him. The Lord will not leave him in his hand, nor condemn him with his judged. Wait on the Lord and keep his way, and he shall exalt thee to inherit the land. When the wicked are cut off, they shall see it. I have seen the wicked in great power, and spreading himself like a green bay tree. Yet he passed away, and lo, he was not yet. I sought him, but he could not be found. Mark the perfect man, and behold the upright, for the end of that man is peace. All right. It says, mark the perfect man, and behold the upright, for the end of the man is peace. But the transgressors shall be destroyed together. The end of the wicked shall be cut off. But the salvation of the righteous is of the Lord. He is their strength and at the time of trouble. And the Lord shall help them and deliver them. And he shall deliver them from the wicked and save them because they trust in him. Amen. And down below this, I have the picture of the lamb with the seven eyes. And I've got a picture of the seven lamps. And a crop circle that I did some time ago, which is the 777, the three pyramids. They represent 777, and each one of the points are pointing to the eighth scroll around the 24 elders, or that bow down around the throne room of God. So that's what that scroll is. That's a symbol of God's, that's what would be worn by the honor guard in God's kingdom. They wear this emblem. This pyramid it's always been about this pyramid. It's always been about attacking God's honor out there in Egypt before man was made, in front of his angels. He built that pyramid in front of the angels, and he built it in such a way to say that he was going to take the Son of God and make him his pet. He planned on trapping God. He planned on snaring God and putting God in his snares and his traps. That's why those three granite stones that are 12 inches across, 12 granite inch stones, three of them lay before the door that goes into the chamber. And the chamber is empty. Just prophecy. He just spoke prophecy, and God just fulfilled the prophecy that he wrote out there in the desert. It's all right there. The altar was built before the Lord right there in Egypt, and it was built by his enemy. And God just needed to name his symbol and take us all the way to the end of the earth, the end of the age, to show us where his symbol belonged and what the enemy's symbol belonged. The enemy's symbol does not work. King of the Hill position does not work. And the enemy has been riding King of the Hill positions ever since Pharaoh. He went to the Caesars, and now he's into the Pontiffs. He's into the whole Rome Catholic thing. He runs that show. That's his show. That's why you cannot trust anything that they say or do. There's nothing greater than adding insult to injury. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images in the heavens above or on the earth below. They've gone out and built an effigy and put an effigy of him on the cross and given him almost a defeatist position. He looks as if he is defeated constantly hanging on that cross. And we know that Christ is not defeated. And God does not like having to look and see what happened to his son. It was a sacrifice once for all. Once for all. When you are born again and you are filled with the Holy Spirit, you don't have to be reminded of what Jesus did for you. You are walking in the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is reminding you day after day after day what his son, what Jesus the Son did for us. I don't need to see Christ being crucified and going through the mass time and time again. That just says I don't accept the first sacrifice. I didn't accept it. It's not good enough for me. I keep going back, and I feel good when I leave the mass because, well, the demons, that was their happy day. That was a happy day for the demons of hell when they seen Jesus go into that cross. That's the one day that they thought they had victory. But they didn't have victory because it was the third day in which Jesus rose up that we received all the victory. And we need to point people to the victory, not the defeated. Jesus Christ is coming back. And I've been honored to let you know that. I've been honored to do these and represent and point to him. I'd rather point to Jesus than look at what the enemy's doing. But you need to see what he's doing in order for you to share it with others and say, look, you need to run away from this group, and you need to run to the foot of the cross because resurrection's coming. You need to destroy your idolatry, and you need to get right with God. This has been episode 37, and thank you for listening. Have a good day, and God bless you.
Godfather, I killed a man.
My son, go to the priest and make a confession. I have many more lives that will need taking. While you're there, sign up with their unlimited plan.
Truth hurts. However, The healing is eternal. You don't drive your car with the headlights off in the dark. So why run your life the same way? Church. Give it a try.